Hi folks, this is video number 108, and the title is John, the series, episode 1. There'll be a few of them. This is the beginning of a series about a guy named John. I heard about him the first day I worked at the plant. This first episode actually took place a couple weeks before my arrival. My electrician friend Bob, aka Puggy, related it to me in a recent email. We put our original product in cartons and sealed them with Findlay white glue. A better reference would be Elmer's glue. It was pretty much the same stuff. For us, it came in 55-gallon drums, and we fed the sealers by hand in those days. We took glue out of the drum by faucet. When the barrel was empty, we had to stand it up. The device it was sitting on accepted the barrel in a similar fashion of a hand truck. Next, you unscrewed the faucet from the used barrel, removed the bung plug from the new one, and screwed the faucet into the lid of the new barrel. Once in that position, the technician would tip the device forward. It had support legs on which it rested, with the barrel in a slightly downward horizontal position, so the glue would run out. The lids were held to the barrel with over-center locking clamp rings. We used a smaller container to transfer glue to the glue trays for the top and bottom flaps. The carton flaps got drips of glue deposited on them as they went past, under, and over the rollers in this area. After the glue was applied, the cartons traveled about 50 feet along a conveyor. It also had a top portion that was set up to keep a slight pressure on the cartons, allowing the glue to set up, thus sealing the carton. Apparently, our co-worker John had some difficulty with the barrel. He was tall and thin and about 6'2". No one knows for sure how it happened, as no one else had trouble with the task. John had wrestled the new barrel into position and moved to the other side of the device. Next, he proceeded to tip the barrel into the usage position. About the time he got the barrel over center, the clamp ring apparently was not fastened correctly, and the lid of the 55-gallon glue barrel came off. John was directly in the flow and could not escape. He could not stand up no matter what. All he could do was flop around. Folks eventually dragged him out and put him on a stretcher. Next, they transported him to the hospital. By the time they got to the hospital, the glue had set up. His clothes had to be cut off because he was stuck to the stretcher. I never heard any follow-up about how this incident occurred, but after working with him for the next 5 years, I came to understand. That's why I named this John, the series. Stay tuned for episode 2.